For more than half a century, dolphins and whales, known as cetaceans, have entertained us with their size, their intelligence, their beguiling smile, and their playful antics. Yet behind that built-in smile lies a dark side of captivity few know anything about. The volatile controversy of taking these fascinating social animals from their families in the wild to a tiny concrete tank in the name of public education.
This show is nothing more than a display of dominance. It teaches us that dominance is good, dominance is right, dominance works.
Rick O'Berry was the trainer for the Flipper television show. For the past 40 years, he has dedicated himself to returning captive dolphins to the wild.
And so the show only serves to perpetuate our insidious utilitarian perception of nature. It is, in fact, a form of bad education. And that's what this issue is all about. It's not just about the 1,000 dolphins in captivity. It's as much about the hundreds of millions of people who go through there and are miseducated, who come out of there thinking they belong here.
I think there probably was, emphasis on the past tense, a real educational value in the 50s and the 60s, maybe into the early 70s.
Dr. John Hall was a marine mammal biologist for SeaWorld. He left that position in the early 90s.
Because a lot of Americans weren't aware of the uniqueness and the capabilities and the lifestyle of these marine mammals, and that one relatively inexpensive way for them to learn about them was to go to marine parks that held these animals in captivity. But I think that function has passed, and I think that basically we're seeing nothing new on the educational horizon that we didn't already know in the early 70s. And that the educational value today is dramatically reduced, if it's present at all. Our increased understanding and ability to conduct non-invasive research in the wild is far more educational than anything that can be gathered today in an oceanarium environment, especially an oceanarium that holds marine mammals.
If you could just make an
When you look at the social life of dolphins and whales, it is difficult to underestimate the fact that their social life is everything to them. There is no such thing as a happy, solitary dolphin. Their lives, their selves, are meant to be defined in relation to their complex social group, in relation to others, who their friends are, who their family is, who their kids are, even who their enemies are. They just cannot be dolphins and whales without other dolphins and whales.
These are very stable, long-term societies. On the coast of British Columbia here, these societies have gone back 10,000 years or more.
Dr. Paul Spong has spent the past 30 years researching wild killer whales that have roamed the coastal waters off Washington State and British Columbia as far back as the Ice Age.
They're, as far as I can tell, very conscious animals. They're very deliberate in the way in which they move, the way in which they relate to one another. And they're successful. You know, they're successful over the long term.